Hello, students. I just want to take a couple of minutes to explain the research assignment to you. So, the research assignment is you joining a larger conversation that you've researched, and the final product will be due December 8th. So, make sure you plan on turning it in then. I do somewhat accept late papers, but not really for the research paper. I prefer that everybody gets it in so that I can help you if you need to revise or whatever it is on that December 8th deadline. So your basic prompt will be that you're going to combine everything that you already know to write a 5 to 7 page research paper. And you're going to need 4 different sources, and there's requirements for this, and I'll show you in just a second. You have 2 different options, but in general, it's still a research paper. And then I kind of put a little inspiration for you guys. Just know that it takes a lot of time, a lot of patience, and endurance. Please don't underestimate this. If you think you're going to finish it up in 2 or 3 days, you're not going to. This is something that's going to take the weeks long that I have planned for you, okay? So option one, your first option is you can create your own argument on any of the topics in the readings in the textbook. So you can do chapter 19, 20, 21, 22, or 23. One's about the planet, one is about the differences that divide us, one's about what college is for, technology, or gender. And I encourage you to read through all of those, and that will give you sort of a general idea of what you might want to do for your narrowed topic. Okay, so that is one option. Your second option would be to choose a topic related to any of the articles in the 1619 Project, and you can write an argumentative research paper on the topic. This means that you're going to need to choose a topic and an issue and then take a side on it, okay? So possible topics, this is one that was in the text or in the Pulitzer information that that was put out for classrooms. So you could take the 1619 Project and you could look at a popular article like Pecan Pioneer or American Music, and you can decide, you know, what other contributions or innovations have African Americans added to the United States, or something that you have experienced personally. And then you can talk about which things should be taught in schools. You can do almost anything as long as it's somehow related to the 1619 Project and it is an argumentative paper. All right, so what the heck's an argument anyways? An argument is basically what you have been doing in your previous assignments. You're going to respond to a narrowed topic with your own opinion. So similar to what we already are doing. We call this our opinion. This opinion is our thesis sentence. So if you weren't really sure what a thesis was before, it's that same statement where you said, I agree, disagree, or both. In previous assignments, we called this our personal response, but it was a thesis just the same. But what do you need to make an argument? It has to be a clear position or opinion, right? I agree, I disagree, I believe, I don't believe. You can always leave those I believes out and just say it as a statement, but you need to make sure it's really clear. Background information, and consideration of others' opinion, right? So joining that conversation. Good reasons and evidence that support, that's where that research comes in. And all of this, there's an entire chapter in Little Seagull on this. So the progression of the assignment. You are first going to do a research proposal in week 11, a source analysis in week 12, a working argument in week 12, an outline in week 14, I'm sorry, week 13, a rough draft in week 14, and the final draft will be due in week 15. I encourage you with every single thing that I have to keep this schedule. Do not get off this schedule. If you get behind, hurry and catch up, because this is how you're going to be successful at doing this paper if you can stay on track. As soon as you listen to this, start looking at the library module and figure out how you're going to do your research for this particular project, okay? The requirements, real quick, just so you know, 5 to 7 pages, 12-point font, double space, please, no quadruple spacing between paragraphs. Have a clear argument, meaning a thesis, and it needs to be clear, organized, and have topic sentences. Acknowledge the conversation that you're joining. There should be MLA style documentation and a works cited page. You need to use 4 sources with no more than 9. Try to start with your book. So that can be your book source. You need 1 source from an ECC database, at least 1 source from a book, which would be our textbook, at least 1 source from a website, and the essay shouldn't rely too much on 1 source. If that's really too difficult, you don't meet all these things, we can talk about it, okay? Do you need help? So I am here for you. I try to be online every Monday night from 6:30 to 8 p.m. You can request a video conference basically during that time or anytime. Just ask me and I'm happy to do that. Also, I'm available by appointment. Alexa is here on Fridays. She is happy to meet with you guys, and often she's there all by herself. She would love to have somebody there and that she can help them with this. The Writing Center is also available to you. You can click on that link. You can go there. There's people at the Writing Center immediately, as well as appointments that you can make. Lastly, when you have created any of these documents, please share your document with me at jholt@elcamino.edu and afindley@elcamino.edu. Make us editors so that we can help you out on your paper. Hopefully that's given you a general idea of how to do this research paper, and more information is to follow for each particular assignment. Thanks.